I remember one time when we were to play Liberia, George Weah, the former World Footballer of the Year, said it that way that if Rasidi Yekini will play, he will play. But if Rasidi Yekini doesn't will not play, he will not play. Naturally, he played that day, and even himself played. And it happens that that very match, we won the match. And in fact, that was even the match that didn't make, what's it called, George Weah to even go to any World Cup football in his football career. That is actually Yekini for me.
Especially when we go play our street football, each time a player scores, he celebrates and said, "I am Rasidi Yekini." I mean, these are memories that are still very fresh in our hearts and our memories. And I hope that in no distant time, the government, the NFF, and also other stakeholders would ensure they come up with a program, sustainable programs that will ensure that the memory of Rasidi Yekini does not just die.
Rasidi Yekini was born in Kaduna on 23rd October 1963 to the family of Alhaji Abdiyekin Olanioye and Madad Sikirat Abdiyekin, native of Ira in Oyo local government of Kwara State. His father died in the year 1979. May Allah have mercy on him. Rasidi Yekini attending Shehu Abdullahi Gbandu LEA Primary School in 1969-75, and also attending secondary school in the year 1975-1980. Later, he was raised in Ibadan. Rasidi Yekini was a footballer who was 1.90 tall, 6 feet 3 inches, and weighing 80 kilograms. Specialized in the position of striker with the shade 9.
Rasidi Yekini, o mo dada omo Iran ni omo re san baba re nje Yekini Abdul Yekini Olabi Oye lo ko baba re baba to baba re nje Olabi Oye mo baba to bi ni nje Yekini en pelu baba ti e wa lo ko to tu ti pe kan ni mo to me ni adagba to fe ma gba ball no pe ni ibi to ti ko bere wa ju le mi ni AF4 just road mo ngi gba na mo gbe tennis ball kan table tennis ball kan ka le fun awon omo yo ma le adugo omo wa ba si omo fi sere nbe o na ma wa ngba o le wa gba lata ru ti o ni mo ti jale mo pe ni ki o ba lo ti jale na o wa ma wahala nibe ti pe ni ale ku mere ni wan to wa lo nlo wa lo school ma ti ti school de ko lo bu mi ma na ti le su a ko tan na be na ni bo wa di pe nbe si be ti mo di pe ni oya o pada si ori apata ko lo ko se ko ko si owo ngba ti ko si owo ni e ti mo ju ya be na lo si di pe ni o de ti ngba ball nti kon practice ni field to wa ni Eli mi kwa tu wa ni casino lo dun bi. Ma ti mpi prasi si mbe ti. Mo pe lo ti lo dide. To de nti lo bu di nti lo ba ba bol ni ni stadium ti mpi prasi si mbe.
Club career. After starting his professional career, he played for many teams, include UNTL Kaduna, IICC Shooting Star of Ibadan, Julius Vega Football Club, Abiola Bees, and Gateway United in all Nigeria. He also played in six other countries. He played for Africa Sport National in Cote d'Ivoire, Vitória de Setúbal in Portugal, Olympiacos in Greece, and Al-Shabaab in Riyadh in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, KSA. International career. Rasidi Yekini represents Nigeria in 58 international matches, include 1998 Seoul Olympic, the 1994 Africa Cup of Nations, two World Cup, 1994 and 1998. During the period spent with Nigeria team, he scored 37 goals to become the highest ever goal scorer for his country.
My little turn of pace. Well, that must be the equalizer, Yekini. And you can see what is happening now. Power.
Rasidi Yekini, most memorable appearance for his country was at the 1998 World Cup, where he scored Nigeria's first ever goal to become the highest in the competition during a 3-0 victory over Bulgaria. Rasidi Yekini, a gagging striker, also named the Africa Footballer of the Year in 1993. He was a retired footballer who played from 1979 to 2009, that is 31 years. His outstanding honor and merit award received cannot be overemphasized.
While he was in Portugal, he was being invited, though he has been playing for the national team as at that time, a very, very top striker, of which any defender or maybe any goalkeeper sees him. We started G3. And I think in Portugal, he played for so many clubs. And I even went to other countries in Europe there before coming down home. And back home, I think he set a record of which, up to now, nobody has even surpassed that record. That is in terms of scoring goals. And that is why everybody is trying to, at least a sort of trying to copy him. That Rasidi Yekini, Rasidi Yekini. We don't know of tomorrow, but as at today, I think that record is still there. I could remember during one Nations Cup qualifying series, that was 1992. Nigeria played with, they call it 1992. It happened that Nigeria forgot their jersey at the dressing room, hotel room. So on getting to the stadium, I think it was even Rasidi Yekini that even suggested that they should cut their tracks with that day, and of which they did. And if I can remember, I think it was only Rasidi Yekini that short suits, because he was tall. Others, they wore oversized shorts that day. And it was even that day, after the match, that I knew Rasidi speaks well, because he was interviewed, and I gave him kudos that day. From what I heard from him. So after the, when he saw that, he has to come back home, he came back home. And when he came back, I think he was even the first footballer to have even come down home to join another local club, of which other players are trying to emulate up to today.
Rasidi Yekini is an icon, agent, pioneer, strong pillar, the big hero, gold father, Nigeria international goal scorer with golden boot, the best striker Nigeria ever had. A devoted Muslim, humble, open to all and honest, he contributes to the development of his country in his own capacity.
Late Rasidi Yekini was a hero and legend of our time, of course, a hero and legend whose memory and exploits can never be forgotten in a very long time to come. Of course, Rasidi Yekini, a very popular and famous footballer, and you want to look at the fact that Rasidi Yekini doesn't live anymore, but despite that, his memory continues to linger. Cut his teeth playing for the national team, talking about the Super Eagles of Nigeria. Of course, 38 goals in 57 matches. And of course, I'm not surprised that up to this very moment, no one has equaled or surpassed Rasidi Yekini's goal scoring record, talking about the Nigerian national team. Of course, late Rasidi Yekini also represented Nigeria in 5 major tournaments, including 2 World Cups, talking about USA 94, when Nigeria made her first appearance in the World Cup, and of course, France 98, 4 years later. Don't forget also that Rasidi Yekini scored the first ever Super Eagles World Cup goal in a 3-0 demolition of Bulgaria in the first group match of, or second group match of the USA 94 World Cup. Of course, Rasidi Yekini also won the Africa Cup of Nations with the Super Eagles in 1994. Talking about Tunis 94, a tournament in which he emerged as the highest goal scorer. So one has a whole lot to talk about Rasidi Yekini. Don't forget also that in 1988 at the Seoul Olympic, Rasidi Yekini also represents Nigeria too. You want to look at Senegal 92, all just talk about goal scoring. You talk about one man who knows how to do his scoring with fantastic, tremendous scoring ability. It's just unfortunate that Rasidi Yekini doesn't live any longer. But the truth is, Rasidi Yekini may have died, but his memory, his good deeds, his goal scoring records, as far as the Nigerian team is concerned, can never and will never be forgotten in a haste. I just hope and pray that the NFF and the Nigerian government, of course, will honor and immortalize Rasidi Yekini, perhaps name one of the stadiums across the country after Rasidi Yekini. And of course, perhaps organize an annual tournament where that will be named after Rasidi Yekini, maybe an under 15, where pool of players will be drawn for our under 17 and name it late Rasidi Yekini Memorial Cup competition. And why not maybe in Ibadan there name a street after Rasidi Yekini, or perhaps name a popular bridge also after Rasidi Yekini, because he's one man who gave all his all, a committed footballer. There's no time he wears the national team a color of Nigeria that he does not give his best. And of course, I remember as a kid then, anytime I'm privileged to watch Rasidi Yekini, my late dad would always say, look, Nigeria is 3 goals up and Rasidi Yekini has not scored. So it means by the time Rasidi Yekini scores, it may be 4, it may be 5. And really, by the time Rasidi Yekini gets on the score sheet, in the end, it will be 5-6 and sometimes 7-0. That's how great Rasidi Yekini was in terms of goal scoring. We've seen many strikers come and go, the likes of Obafemi Martins, Yaku Aigbeni. These were strikers who also distinguished themselves playing for the national team. But I tell you, none of these strikers come, with due respect to them, and come close to Rasidi Yekini in terms of the number of goals, in terms of his record, in terms of his exploit and all of that. So for me, I think the government and the NFF have not done enough in order to immortalize Rasidi Yekini, even though some individuals some time ago went to his family's mother, to be precise, made some cash donations and all of that. For me, I think it is not enough. There's nothing we do to immortalize Rasidi Yekini that is just enough, because it's one man who has died 5 years now. I think it was May 4th, 2012, and up to this very moment, when you ask about Rasidi Yekini, they tell you goal scoring, goal scoring, goal scoring and all of that. So for me, I think stakeholders also should also come in and find a way of immortalizing Rasidi Yekini so that his memory will for a very long time linger in the heart of others. And of course, ask kids on the street those days, they tell you, I want to be like Rasidi Yekini. Growing up then, there's only one name that comes to the lips of every Nigerian, especially when we go play our street football. Each time a player scores, he celebrates and said, I am Rasidi Yekini. I mean, these are memories that are still very fresh in our hearts and our memories. And I hope that in no distant time, the government, the NFF, and also other stakeholders would ensure they come up with a program, sustainable programs that will ensure that the memory of Rasidi Yekini does not just die and of course be forgotten like others that have served this country whose memory have been forgotten.
Rasidi Yekini died at Ibadan on 4th May 2012 at the age of 48 years. May Allah reward him with Aljana Fidus. Amen. He was buried at his residence in Ira in Kwara State, according to a Muslim guide. He was survived by a wife, three children, and eight mother. May all Almighty Allah grant Mama peace of mind, the good heart, to the rest of her life. Amen.
Well, contrary to many insinuations, Rasidi Yekini is the son of Yekini Olabiyi of Esa's compound in Ira. His mother is from Ojomo's compound in Ira. So his mother and his father are from Ira. He just, when Rasidi started living in Ibadan, when he joined Shooting Stars, IICC. So there's no way you could call him from Ibadan. Although he started, like I said earlier, he started his career in Kaduna where he was born. But when he joined Shooting Stars, maybe he liked the environment, he relocated to Ibadan. That does not make him from Ibadan or from Ofa. Because he built a house for his brother in Ofa. But he has a house in Ira. So he's never from Ibadan, he's from Ira. Esa's compound. His father's name is Yekini Olabiyi. Anybody who says Rasidi Yekini is from Ibadan is making a mistake. Rasidi is from Ira. Ira in Onyo local government area of Kwara State.
I was buried at Ira Kwara State and his status is still in Ibadan, Oyo State, because he died there and they love him. That's why they have his status there. So to me, Rasidi Yekini is a good striker. My advice for upcoming players too, I'll say they should keep doing what they know best. They should keep good orientation, because if Rasidi Yekini doesn't do that, people will have forget about him before now. Talk more of talking about him now. So you should just be good in anything you are doing. If you want to be a striker, if you want to be a keeper, you know what you're good at. Be good and focus on what you're doing. And importantly, have a very good attitude and character, because with attitude and character, you will definitely go far. So that's just my advice for upcoming player.
The upcoming youths that want to take football as a career, I want to advise them that they should know that this football of the team has age limit. It is not a game that you play forever. And that is why at the usual time of your age, you try and do what is needful. You see, try to copy from others. Some people are falling, and those ones that are falling, you know, we are not trying to say they are not wise. It was just circumstances that led to that. But I think by now, the upcoming youth should be able to know and learn from them. There are some of them that have played active football and they are still in football. Even if they are not more playing active football, at least they have gotten something and which they can live on till the day of their last day. So I want to advise the youth, if you are taking to football as your career, please remember that it has limit. By the time you are getting to the age of 35, 40, maybe at most 42, you can no more play active football. So whatever you have gotten between that time is what is going to be what you are going to live on. So please, always make use of the advantage so that you don't regret the future.
Well, he tried a lot, but God loved him best. And really, I miss him. Even with the entire Kenny's family, he miss him a lot. But God loves him than us. I just wish him a journey of doubts. So the government didn't do anything, they just made a promise and they didn't fulfill the promise. These individual people that assist us, assist our mother. And I wish them good luck. All what they do, God will reward them.
Amen.
Individual people, not the governments.
Amen.
Nina tare da su ina advice din su da su dinga zama masu discipline first, domin discipline shine the most very important. Har na gama kwallo ko yellow card ba a taba bani ba, even yellow card ba a taba bani ba har na gama gol. To shine nake kullun na ba yara advice da su yi koyi da haka wurin keeping time. Idan an ce maka 3 o'clock 2:30 kana nan, idan an ce maka 4 o'clock 3:40 kana wurin, ya rage 40 minutes, it regular 20 minutes, 30 minutes, you are there. Kai keeping time. Kuma the instruction, the management suka baka, kai iya batun kokarin ka akai. Mu ba mun buga kwallo muna neman kudi bane, mun buga ball ne dan mai suna, kuma Allah ya sa an san mu din. So saboda haka we thank God, mun gode wa Allah a wannan time da Allah ya kawo mu ga mu muna da rai, muna da lafiya. Har yanzu kuma ana yin muna cikin wannan system din na football. Sometime yara sukan zo neman advice ma ina basu. Ko fili na je na ga wani mistake, na kan shiga tsaye da ball, nuna musu correct in that best way da ya kamata su. To haka muke kowane lokaci, ina gaya musu kuma ko ina bacci su zo su lock it in over na. In dai advice ne zan basu, wannan na yi alƙawari. At any time kuma suke da wasa ko ina ne ina gudu su ina watch. Saboda mu har yanzu muna cikin system ɗin. ya'yanmu ne, in mun basu sun lalace mun cuce kanmu ne. shi sa ko ina yara suke suke wasa muka tsaya mu kalla mai advice din su ba za mu rena football ba a cikin ball Allah ya mana wannan arziki ya ya ga komai Allah ya ba mu garibin asiri ba mu da wani matsala insha Allah
lola to wani gogo me goni mu tiri manera ni yi fa ko fa se kan yi ya bi de mi wa lola wa ya wo ru ogo wa omo to si bi omo te to bi kan arowo ti an fun mi ni se gbe wa na mo fo mo Rasidi lo lo mo ni mo fun emi ri n pa dure mi ri deyin owo ti an fun ajo mejo se ni to ran mi lowo ni o si dubai lo ni lo n kan ba mi je
Don't forget our heroes. Try to appreciate them. Value them. Try to be remember them. God bless Ira. God bless Kwara State. And God bless Federal Republic of Nigeria.
See you next time.